North Woods are an ideal laboratory for studying black bears close up before they emerge from their winter dens.
It's a lifestyle. We do this not for a paycheck. We're doing it because it's like, there's no better job. This is as good as it gets.
At some point, it becomes so routine that you forget how unique it is and how fortunate you are to get to experience this type of work.
There are 10,000 black bears in Maine. 1,200 are killed by hunters every year. While the bear population is not in danger, this long-term study will help determine if the bears can continue to sustain that kill.
To me, there's nothing like a bear.
It is special.
This is a directional antenna. Where the signal gets louder. Source is probably in the den.
When I came in the early 80s, George had taken over a few years prior. And he was really the architect of actually improving the study.
This is the first time that we've introduced cubs to a female here in Maine. We felt that we had a pretty good chance of success, but we didn't know until we tried it.
When I first came on, they didn't have a whole lot of data. I knew we could catch more bears and have a bigger sample size.
George was able to gain the funding for it to improve the equipment we had.
After her physical is completed, her radio collar is replaced. It will last another year and help scientists keep tabs on her social life.
Things slowly but surely became more and more expanded. Part of the study has been the ability to actually handle the animals themselves. I think it gave you a sense that you were very much connected with the conservation and the management of that species. If you were handling an animal, you weren't sitting in a computer room looking at dots on a screen.
You have to love what you're doing and know how important the data you're collecting is, you know, to the management of the species.
Early on, people considered bears a creature of the wilderness, pure wilderness. Well, we know bears are in your backyards now as much as anywhere, right? They're very adaptable. They're just an animal that inspires awe. We've had many, many folks come through the program. You pick good people and you train them well. It becomes very much a team.
Well, not really sure what possessed George to hire me, but he did, and it changed my life.
He stood out to me because he was so honest with his answers, you know.
I'm just a regular old farm boy from Maine. Probably helped me push myself to be the best I can.
Starting out with Randy and being a wee little lad, there was so much I had to learn. You can't have a better teacher. And got me to where I am.
I'm definitely the only wildlife biologist in my family, so I think they think it's cool, but they might not totally understand what I do on a day-to-day basis at work.
I mean, I had heard so much about this program prior to this job opening up, and so, you know, I feel like this bear study in Maine is kind of famous in a way. It's one of the longest consecutively running bear studies in North America.
We have a healthy bear population in Maine. We have a good balance, I feel like, compared to other states of our bear population and the human population.
We have to live in a world where people have to coexist with wildlife, and sometimes there's negative interactions between people and the wildlife. So that's what management is. We're trying to make sure populations continue to persist and that they're in balance with both the natural environment and just living in among people.
You know, I'm lucky I get to go out in the field and getting out there and reminding myself of why I got into this work in the first place, which is getting to work with bears.
This is Matt's snack of choice.
you know, you get the adrenaline rush. It's addictive. Like, it's hard to turn it off.
One of the things that's intangible is someone who has good woodsmanship. You have to learn that.
Being able to transport ourselves, that's probably the most logistically challenging and sometimes maybe even one of the more dangerous pieces of our job, rather than interacting with the bears themselves.
You don't have to be a world-class athlete, but boy, you have to have a certain level of athleticism. We're really stressing their bodies.
So we're in the woods with nothing. Like, we don't have the space to carry other things. So we just go in there with our handling equipment. Being comfortable, being uncomfortable. Like, you're hot, you're cold, you're happy, you're mad. All that at the same exact time.
It's really enjoyable because that's one of the few moments where, you know, I can't get emails on my phone and I can't get all phone calls and text messages. And so it's really nice to be out in really remote parts of the state and just to see the wildest parts of Maine.
So radio telemetry, that's how we get to 100% of our bears.
So we've used VHF radio collars since 1975 that give off a radio signal that we can use our telemetry to get us close to the bear.
I think arguably one of the hardest parts of telemetry is just that mental mind game of, like, you have people following you and expecting you to take them to a bear.
Long gone.
She left a while ago.
Depending on the den that you're approaching, I mean, you do have to be very quiet at times, especially if they're just in a ground nest, just watching and listening and smelling. We have one or two people approach the den with the syringe pole with the drugs on the end. And then we have two technicians who have dart rifles in case a bear were to run.
They're scared of you. Mostly they're gonna pose and they're gonna bluff. But somewhere out there is a bear with a screw loose. It can happen, it's a numbers game. So that's always in the back of your head.
On top of being in a situation that most people wouldn't put themselves in, you also have this responsibility for the welfare of the animal. And so I think that, to me, is more stressful than actually crawling into a bear den.
We'll pull the cubs out and start taking measurements on them and collect all sorts of morphological measurements.
7.2.
You know, body size, length, width.
In total, on a good year, we're handling close to 300 bears. You have the opportunity to really learn things that most people would never even think about trying because they're only dealing with 30 or 40 bears, say. In the back of your head, you know that what you're doing is helping us manage bears properly in the state of Maine. And to me, the most magnificent animal in the woods.
This study has been going on for 50 years now, and the data that we've collected over that time in a very consistent way gives us such a window into how the bear population has been doing. And so being able to collect data into the future on how the population is doing, what's the size of the population, where is it located, distributed across the landscape, helps us make decisions to manage the population to keep it at such a stable level, so that generations from now, people can still go out into the Maine woods and see a black bear, go out into the Maine woods and go hunting, and have all these different experiences that we're able to have now.
if you have a species that's worth managing, put the effort into it that you need to do, you know? And there's not much substitute for a good long-term study.
It's all about a lot of good people wanting to do good work and wanting to do that good work for the benefit of a really phenomenal species.
We don't want it to go backwards and have any concerns about how the population is doing. And so that gives me maybe more satisfaction. I don't have to make things better. I just need to make sure that we have a future where bears are continuing to thrive in the state of Maine.
You'd think, well, you have all these bears, you've done this for all these years, it must get old and get boring. It never gets old, never gets boring. It's really cool.
The biologists declare them healthy. Still, we have a lot to learn about bears, and going to where the bears are is the only way to do it.
I can't be serious about anything.